try this. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Serve the Lord. Kumbaya, my Lord. Kumbaya. Kumbaya, my Lord. Kumbaya. Come by here, my Lord. Come by here. Someone's praying, Lord. Come by here. Someone's crying, Lord. Come by here. Somebody's hurting, Lord. Come by here. But God also, somebody's rejoicing. So come by here. Have your way in this worship experience on today. God, we're here with great anticipation for the coming of your son, Jesus. We commemorate it. We remember it like it was yesterday because Jesus is born in us every day. It's in the mighty and the matchless name of Jesus we pray. And all God's children said amen, amen, and amen. Listen, I'm just a noisy kind of guy. And I believe everything that have breath ought to praise the name of the Lord. Now, y'all didn't know I was watching y'all, but I've been watching y'all. I've seen some of you in your house and you were watching the ball game and you gave the Pistons more praise than this. I've been watching y'all. Listen, the Lions finally won a game and y'all went crazy. But can I tell you something? I wouldn't praise nobody greater than I give God glory and I give God honor and I give God. Because listen, who woke you up this morning? Who gave you activity of your limbs? Who started you on your way? I believe somebody will say, oh, what a pretty little baby. Oh, what a pretty little baby. And just in case you're wondering, Jesus is his name. Come on, choir. Hallelujah. 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 Listen, I don't know about you, but I have never in my life been so excited about the birth of a little bitty baby. Listen, I remember when Amber Nia was born. Wonderful. But listen, there's nothing like the birth of Jesus. There's nothing like Jesus being birthed down on the inside. Somebody ought to have the correct response. Does anybody know what the correct response to the birth of Jesus is? Hallelujah. 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 Oh, I'm feeling that. Come on, choir. We can be unorthodox. We don't have to stay with the hallelujah.
This birth of Jesus. And so at this time, we want to invite the Gaddis family to come and lead us as we light this Advent candle. Amen.
We light this candle to remind us of how God's perfect love is found in Jesus. God sent Jesus into the world because of his great love for us. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through him. And that is found in John 3:16-17. Amen.
Church, say amen. Amen. Church, say praise the Lord. Amen. At this time, as we move forward in worship, first of all, we thank and praise God for the Gaddis family and all those families that led us in lighting of the Advent candles during this Advent season. The Reverend Underwood will come now, lead us further in worship by sharing the Word of God. Word of God is still a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path. Hear ye the Word of God. After the Word of God, Reverend Underwood will lead us to the throne of grace. Lead us before the Lord in prayer. Anybody know prayer changes things? Anybody know you can call him when you want to, and God will hear and answer our prayers? Amen. And then following that, it's good to have something you believe. And the worst thing is to call yourself believing something and you won't tell folks about it. So after that, Reverend Underwood will lead us in our affirmation of the faith we have in Jesus Christ. Let's move forward in worship. Amen.
God bless you.
This morning's scripture can be found in the gospel according to Luke, the second chapter, and starting at the 8th verse. Luke chapter 2, starting at verse 8 and concluding at verse 14. And the King James Version of the Word of God speaks it so. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace, goodwill toward many. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be unto God. Father God, it's again another time that your children come before your throne of grace, Lord, first to say thank you. Lord God, we thank you that you loved us so much that you watched over us as we slumbered and slept. You woke us up with your finger touch of love. You provided for us this morning, Lord God. You gave us something to eat. You gave us a place to sleep. You gave us clothes to wear. You gave us a way to get to your house just to say thank you. Father God, we stand here thanking you for the greatest gift you could ever give your children, and that is your only begotten Son. For Father God, we have not done all that you have asked us to do, called us to do, directed us to do, showed us to do. But we were able to come to you after we said that we believe in your Son, Jesus Christ, that we believe he is the Savior of the world, that we believe he is your Son, that we believe he is the Word embodied in flesh as the example on how we ought to live, how we ought to love, how we ought to act, and what we ought to do in your name, God. Father, we thank you. Lord God, you could have just let us go on our way and be crazy in our foolishness. But Lord God, you loved us beyond what we could even love ourselves. And you saw a need to draw us back to you, to bring us back to the place where you put us. Besides all that that went on in Eden, besides all that has gone on through all these generations, Lord God, you still loved us because you had a purpose for us. So that virgin birth, that young lady Mary who said, I know I've not been with a man, so how can I be pregnant? But Father God, your angels explained it to us. And her cousin Elizabeth's baby leaked in confirmation that you were bringing us the Messiah. For that, Lord, we say thank you. Lord God, we thank you that we have a way to get back in line when we get all out of our place and we think we know better than those you put over us, Lord God. And we know all, but we know nothing without you, Lord. So, Father, we stand this morning first asking you to forgive us for our ugliness, for our decisions that were against your word. We thank you, Lord God, that you loved us enough to accept us, accept our asking for forgiveness, Lord God, and putting our mind back on you. So, Lord God, as we continue in this worship service, hallelujah, Father, celebrating your birth, Jesus. Hallelujah, celebrating a pastor that is not ashamed to show you the glory you deserve, Father God, who brings us the word. We thank you. We bless you for all the pastors you've provided us to in the past. But, Lord God, we look toward the future with this pastor that you placed here now. So, Lord God, as we continue in this service, let the service be glory to you, God. What the Christian Education Department has for us, what the music ministry has for us, Father God, we ask that you open our hearts, turn the soil of our hearts So those seeds of your word and song and enactment can fall fresh, take root, and send us to do what you have sent for us to do. Lord, we love you. I can stand here until you call me home and tell you how much we love you and we thank you. But it won't even be enough. So we ask that you accept this humble prayer as a remembrance that you are our God. You love us beyond ourselves. And you are here to make things right for us. If we only trust and believe in you, that's what Proverbs 3:5-6, trust in the Lord with all thine heart and lean not into thy own understanding and all thy ways. Acknowledge him and he shall direct your path. In your name, Jesus, we pray and count it done. Amen. Amen. In our affirmation of faith, what we stand and believe on is that God is. God is. And it says, oh, okay, I was wondering. Heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. Third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. You may be seated.
Amen, amen, amen. My brothers and sisters, I believe in being fresh and unique and creative in worship. There's nothing like stale worship. Every now and then, you got to do something different. Amen. And so we want to freshen it up this morning. We're going to be unorthodox this morning. And so I am excited that I am going to present to you the music department and the Christian education department of St. Paul AME Zion Church as they creatively worship the Lord and present a message, an Advent message unto God on this Sunday morning. Won't you receive the music department and the Christian education department of St. Paul AME Zion Church? Amen. Amen.
than 2,000 years ago, a woman named Mary and a man named Joseph were preparing to be married. One day, an angel came to Mary and told her she was going to have a child. The angel said that his name was to be called Jesus. The baby would be the Son of God, the Savior. This baby would fulfill prophecies and save a dying world. For unto us a child would be born. But Jesus would be no ordinary child. No, he would be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. And so Mary and Joseph made their way to the House of Bread, a town called Bethlehem, where the king had ordered a census. When they arrived, the town was very crowded. Alas, there was no room for Mary to give birth to this child of promise. So Mary and Joseph were forced to spend the night in a place where animals were kept. It was on the night that God transformed the stable into a sanctuary. In a humble manger, Jesus was born. A new star appeared in the sky, shining so bright that it could be seen far, far away to the east. As shepherds watched over their flocks in nearby fields by night, angels came and told the shepherds that the Savior has been born. The shepherds went to find and worship the baby Jesus. Far away, wise men saw the new star. They knew it was a sign that the Savior had been born. And so they set out following that star, searching, hoping to find this child who would change the world, saying, "Come, come, let us adore him." Thank you. As the wise men continued on their journey, they followed the star until finally there in the stable, wrapped in swaddling clothing, they found Jesus. They had brought fine gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And bowing in humble adoration, they gave him presents and worshiped him. Born this day in a town called Bethlehem, a child who would change the world, a child who would give us the greatest gift, a child who would save mankind and bring us peace, a savior, Jesus. Oh, what a night, what a beautiful holy night.
The stars of life shine in the night of our King's birth. Thank you.
Divine, oh night, oh night, divine. I dare you. Fall on your knees. Oh, can't you hear the angel's voice? Oh, night, it was divine, oh, night, oh, night. Now listen, this is a good time to worship the Lord. I don't care how you worship the Lord. I'm being extreme. I'm on my knees, but I don't care how messed up this suit gets, because God is worthy of all the praise, all the worship, all the glory and the honor. Sometimes we need to come out the box and do something extraordinary for God. If you never lifted your voice before, lift your voice now and give God glory. If you never clapped your hands before, begin to clap your hands and praise the Lord, because he's worthy of all the honor, all the glory, oh yes. Fall on your knees.
those of you that have your Holy Writ now, I know some of y'all are real looking real strange. You're like, well, you see that on the worship guide? It said that the invocation was going to come after. But there is something that I need to say to you. It's called the
We want to stay in the cool group. We want to stay with the crew. And so we treat people wrong. We do wrong because we don't want to be there. But listen, there is no excuse for doing wrong. We've got to do justly. And my brothers and sisters, to me, peace is worth going against the grain and doing the right thing, no matter how many people are doing the wrong thing. Peace is better. Water, come light or unlight, come popular or unpopular, I gotta do the right thing, Spike Lee. I know y'all have watched them movies, but and so not only do we have to do justly, but we have to love mercy. We have to love mercy. My brothers and sisters, it's hard for us to have mercy. We love proving folk wrong. And can I tell you what else we love? We love punishing folk for doing wrong. Throw the book at them. Give them this, do this, do that. My brothers and sisters, do you love mercy? Do you love it when you can look somebody in the eye that has done you wrong and you can say to them, listen, it's okay. Don't worry about it. We're going to move on from here. Listen, my brothers and sisters, do you love it when you are right in a conversation and when you realize and everybody realizes you're right, you say, that's okay, you don't gloat. I told y'all. Told y'all, y'all didn't know what y'all was talking about. Is there anybody that loves mercy? Listen, you don't have to punish people. You glory in punishing people. You don't glory in people. You don't glory in giving people a hard time. So it's wrong. Listen, people that are going to be just people. People that are going to be peace are going to be people that love being merciful. And then finally, people that are going to have peace through justice, love mercy, and walk humbly before your God. Here it is. I thank the trustees of whoever found on this platform. Thank y'all. I'll see you in the next one.
complex. But listen, watch this. Walk humbly before God. I'm standing respectful in front of God. But when I come before God, I got to come on in platform on God. I got to lower myself and hear the gospel. Before God. In front of y'all, but I keep the rest in front of God. God is King of Kings. God is Lord of Lords. And I got to humble myself when I come before God. When I come before God, I feel the rest. When I come before God, I'm absolutely nothing. Is there any time that won't teach bad enough to
humble yourself? If you was that bad, you'd already have peace. But you got to humble yourself before the Lord. In order, some of us can't find peace because we're not doing the right thing. We're not doing justice. You can't do wrong and then talk about, why can't I sleep at night? The Lord keeping you up. You can't want peace and always poking at folks and not showing them mercy.
Come on.
Why we gotta call 30 people when we find out somebody slipped and fell?
Come on.
Amen, lights. I think that chandelier said amen. Why we can't just keep it to ourselves and pray for that brother or that sister? We gotta learn how to love mercy. And then we gotta love how to walk humbly. Listen, ain't nothing great in us but God. And nothing big and bad about us but God. We got to stay humble when we walk in the presence of God. Be careful. I didn't say be no pushover. I ain't say let nobody mistreat you. Because, you know, we take humility to a whole nother level sometimes. Sometimes you should pop somebody upside the head. No, I'm sorry. But my brothers and sisters, that ain't what I'm talking about. I'm talking about you should always be in the presence of God. And if you're in the presence of God, you got to be humble. You got to show some humility because in front of God, we're absolutely nothing.
Amen.
Well, I heard a song once sung, let there be peace on earth and let it begin with me. Let there be peace on earth. It's the peace that was meant to be with God as our Father. Brothers, all are we. Let me walk with my brother in peace and harmony. Let peace begin with me. Let this be the moment now. With every breath I take, let this be my solemn vow to take each moment, to live each moment in peace and harmony. Let peace be on earth and let it begin, not with my brother, not with my sister, not with my uncle, not with my cousin, but let it begin with me. Say yeah, 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 with peace, like a river attendeth my way when sorrow like sea billows roll. Whatever my lot thou hast taught me to say, it is well, it's well, it's well with my soul, with my soul, with my soul. Your peace comes from Jesus in your soul. Peace, please. All I want for Christmas is peace, please. All I want under my tree is peace, please. Which comes from God our Father. The good news of the Advent season is you can have peace like never before. When peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like sea billows Of peace. If you need introduction to the Prince of Peace, we can make those introductions on this morning. But some of you have forgotten the Prince of Peace. Some of you don't remember the Prince of Peace. God, I pray you bring them back to remembrance. Help people to know that no matter what happens on this world, peace is a gift to every one of us through the baby Christ Jesus. If you do what's right, if you quit being hard on folk, and if you keep your self-esteem under Jesus Christ, you can have peace. No food, but you'll have peace. No job, but you'll have peace. Struggling in your marriage, but you'll have peace. Because God will grant peace that surpasses all understanding. I'm so grateful for the peace of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Sister Vanessa. That's a great place to be. Come let us adore him. To rededicate themselves, I'm not going to ask you to come up front. If you want to lift up your hand, we're going to pray for you. If there's one that wants to give their life back to Jesus Christ, we won't ask you to come up front right now. If you just lift up your hand, we'll pray the prayer of salvation with you. Oh, come, adore him. Gracious God, we thank you for this day. We thank you, God, in the name of Jesus, for every soul that's represented here today. God, we thank you for those that want salvation. God, they're confessing with their mouth and they're believing in their heart the Lord Jesus. God, if they're in virtual land, have them to send us a sign that they're giving their life to Jesus Christ so we can write their name on the road. God, we pray for those that are in the sanctuary. God, bless them for their perseverance. Bless them for the extra effort to tie that tie or to put on that suit and make their way to the house of the Lord. God, we pray right now for peace like a river that comes to all those that love you and accept your son Jesus as the gift of all gifts. God, pour peace into their lives. Pour peace into their heart. Pour peace into their circumstances. In the name of Jesus. God, you promise in your word that the Prince of Peace would come. And so, God, we welcome the Prince of Peace. God, touch those that have had to bury loved ones. Touch those that are searching for jobs. Touch those that have gone under the knife for surgery. Touch all those that have issues that they need your help. We pray for this church. God, we need a fresh anointing. God, I pray in the name of Jesus that you move in St. Paul in a mighty way. God, come down and rain from heaven like never before on the ministry. God, not that we might get any glory, but all the glory and all the honor goes to you, oh God. Let this neighborhood feel the presence of this church. Let this city feel the presence of this church. But more importantly, let you, God, feel the ministry of this church. God, we love you. And we're going to serve you like never before. Because we're thankful for the gift of Advent. We thank you for the gift of Jesus Christ. It's in your son Jesus' name that we pray. Amen. 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 Come, let us all. I dare you, lift your voice. Him rise. Now let's do an application. Let's do an experiment. Think about how you adore some things. You got that thing in your mind that you adore? Ladies, if it's that guy that you adore, you get all big eyed, start giggling and carrying on, start smirking. Some of us been frowning since we've been in here. I dare you to adore the Lord. I dare you to begin to smile at the Lord. Start giggling because you adore Jesus Christ and how good God's been to him. And if you do that, it don't matter what's happening outside of here. There's a joy down on the inside. I'm going to look straight ahead up in the balcony where nobody is. Fellas, you know how that you adore that man cave. You go down there and look at it. Got your big screen. Got your refrigerator with your soft drinks in it. If you're like me, you got a popcorn machine in there. And I adore that space. I adore that thing. There's a lot of stuff. Listen, I'm going to tell on Chris. Chris adores his cars. I ain't never seen Chris with a dirty car. That's a sign of adoration. Can I get a witness? Listen, Chris be up. Soon as it snow, soon as the snow stop, here he go outside wiping off his stuff. So here's my question to you. What do you do to adore Jesus? What's the look on your face? What's your posture when you begin to adore God and how good Jesus Christ is to you? That ain't fair for you. How Jesus going to know? He's going to know you adore him if you never show a sign. I dare you right now, show Jesus you adore him. Do something to show him you adore him. Let him move in your heart. And guess what? If you adore him, he'll adore you. And everything will be all right. Oh. Christ. Come on, give God praise. Come on, give God glory. Thank you, Lord. Amen. You may be seated in the presence of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. My fantastic ladies,
They was up on their feet during worship. Can we go fantastic after church? Some of us are exercised by jumping up and clapping our hands during service. But God is worthy of the honor, the praise, and the glory. Amen. Let me see how mature you are. Some of us look mature. I want to see how mature we are. Can you worship through giving? That's the test. That's the barometer in which you measure maturity in Jesus Christ. Can you worship through giving? And so I'm going to call on the stewards to lift an offering unto the Lord, not unto St. Paul. Remember, unto the Lord, not unto St. Paul. Remember, unto the Lord, not unto St. Paul. At this time, the stewards are coming. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor Jarrett. Good morning, St. Paul friends and family. I'm kind of awestruck. This is my first time being in the sanctuary in, 2 years? And I'm put on the spot, but that's where God wants me to be, on the spot. Thank you, Pastor Jarrett, for those words, sermon. Beautiful, beautiful. At this time, I know you guys have probably been filling out envelopes. I haven't been here, but I think that's the process this morning. You fill out your envelope and there will be a basket over on the Lawrence Street side for you to put your offering in. Okay? I did mine online yesterday. And if you did yours yesterday or Friday, Thursday, that's fine. I love you. But that's all I have for today. Brother Felder, is there anything I forgot? He's gone. He'll let me fly today. So God bless you all. Have a nice Christmas.
Church, say amen. Amen. Let's bless this offering. As you're giving, either you've already given, you're giving right now, or you'll give shortly. Can we bless it?
Yes,
do y'all realize God can take whatever we give and multiply it? Do you really believe that? And so let's bless this offering as an act of faith so that God can blow on it and bless it for the kingdom. Amen. All things truly come from thee, O Lord. And of thine own have we given. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the precious Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I want to make sure I haven't gotten anything here. No, we're going to hold off on that. Amen. Well, come on. Praise God. From whom all the blessings flow. Praise God. Every creature here below. Praise God for the Father, for the Son, and for the Holy Ghost. Amen, amen, amen. Come on, jump to your feet all over the church. Praise God. Praise God from whom? Abundantly above that which we can ask or even think. He's the only wise God, our Savior. And so unto him be all the glory, be all the majesty, and be all the power. As you go out, as you come in your down sitting, in your uprising, in all you do, in your work and your play, the Lord bless you. The Lord keep you. The Lord cause his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. And all of the people of God, they began to sing, amen, amen, amen. In agreement, the angels, the seraphim and cherubim began to cry out, amen. We're going to call on the Reverend Rick Lee to come now and share our announcements. After Reverend Lee comes, I will give a couple of announcements myself, and then we'll be ready for fantastic. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God.
Amen.
From whom all blessings.
Amen. Amen.